Confirm in chat. Okay, thank you. So introducing about me. Okay. So today we are going to discuss what we are going to study. That's what we are going to discuss. And then we'll go with demo sessions. Any question? I have 10 years of experience in total. And I have completed CCA 175 as a Spark and Hadoop developer certification 1 year back, and then GCP professional data engineer. These two certification I just completed, and in a training experience I have close to 4 years with. So it's completely in big data profile only. Okay. And for this class introductions. So we just split into the four category. So environment. And then session discussion. And materials. And what are the ecosystems you are going to study? And projects. Okay, fine. So mostly it will be updated in the syllabus itself, I hope. So here, that environment before we have used CloudRun environment. CDH 5.13, but right now it was closed and it will be migrated to CDS versions, and they will be provided only 2 months. So that we just verifying if it is possible, we can go with 5.13. Otherwise we will go with our own pseudo distributor. With Hadoop 3. Hadoop 3x components completely. And latest, whatever the changes will happen, that will be updated into the pseudo distribution VM itself. Installation will be covered from our end. And if you have any issues with the VM, we will be working with you. And sessions, already I told you, it's not a fast track. Whatever I'm doing right now, like that, the session will go slowly. The reason behind, I have seen in my experience, I can see with the technical people and non-technical. Both will be connected. So we cannot balance them both, so that we just planning to go with only in slow trainings only. So if you have any doubts in the discussions, you can raise me at the time itself. Once you clear, then only we will go for the next topics. That's we planned. Okay, any doubts, any question? Okay.
When you say it's not a fast track, what do you mean?
No, it's not a fast track. It's completely based on syllabus, whatever we have provided, we will be covered that. And anyone have doubts in that part, we will be clear, then only we go for the next.
Okay.
Because the training quality we will be expecting, so that we just going with slow track one day. So someone will understand some concept and few will not be understand, especially non-technical people. So we just cover and we will be clearly explained to them, then only we go for the next topics, whatever.
Okay.
Okay. So as per previous batch feedback, 4 days we will go with classes, trainings. Can you mute yourself? If you have doubt, you just unmute and ask me, then go further to mute. So 4 days training discussions and 1 day will be your doubts. Because I am taking some training and I can do my hands-on by my own, but you cannot understand. And while you are trying, you may face a few issues. So that we will be clear entirely. Each component, once we taken, I will do that hands-on, but you have to do it from your end as well. So if you are facing any issues, we just want to work with you. And that is also will be recorded and providing you, because you will learn what the issues you have faced. In future, the same issue if you faced, you can understand how to over it. So that's we just planning for 4 days training and 1 day for doubt discussions. So it should be an interactive only. We will not be moving with any slides. Okay, we have a slide, we can go with that, but mostly we will be interactive mode. So if you have a doubt or anything, we will be discussed. And concept only. So interactive sessions. Okay, I will cover with 30% theory. Obviously, you need to know what is the concept, then go with 70% hands-on. This is our agenda. So syllabus entirely will be following with that. And then batch count, mostly maximum 14 members plus one old student. So sometimes they will be facing some personal issues, so they cannot continue at the time. So they will be joined again in this batch, but only one member can allow maximum. Because if you are maintaining with multiple people, we cannot balance them. And if they have a rise to any questions, we cannot complete that and go for the next topic. So we just restricted maximum 14 members only in a batch. And this batch will be created into the private WhatsApp group. As we discussed, I just mentioned the syllabus itself. Why this WhatsApp group? If you will be going to face any interviews or any stuck ups in that big data concept, we will help you to clarify in that. Okay, any doubts in this? And important, I forgot to tell you, 100% I will refund your amount in case you are not satisfied with me, my communications and whatever. So if you are not satisfied, we will refund you 100% without questioning you. But we will be maintaining with few sessions only. Yeah, any question?
Hello, this is Shiva. How much fee are you charging?
That's, I just mentioned the nomination form for the big data classes, 14,000 will be charges.
So what about timings, only morning or any other evening? Like,
which one?
Timing.
There is same timing, 7 o'clock only every day morning. So week days batches only Monday to Friday.
Thank you.
Okay. Clear? Any other question? So classroom also will go the same, how we are going to discuss here now. The same is going for the classroom as well. Next, materials. So session information. So what is going to be covered? Already we have provided in syllabus itself and recorded videos. So whatever we'll be taking the trainings, that will be recording. That recording will be sharing to you. That's the reason I'm just asking for that your email ID. So we will be providing the access to you. So you can get from Google Drive and rework with your practice in case if you have any doubts. That this will help you for references. And each topic once covered, we will be providing some assignments. And assignments discussion also will be covered. If you are facing any stuck ups and you will not get clear answer, we will be guiding you. But one day we will give you the timings. You have to do it by your own. And class notes. So whatever we will be discussing, this kind of notes we will be sharing you with materials. Hands-on material. Both will be giving to you. Okay, so these are all you'll get. Here, any question? I hope no. We'll go for the next. So ecosystems, it will cover with Hadoop, SHDFS. And then Hive session will be covered. Then Scope. And then Spark. Spark 2x version will be covered. And if 3x released, that all the ecosystem will be N minus one version, mostly will be covered, and the stable version only. And recently, who are all is using Hive also in 2x. Scope 1.4.7, Spark 2x, and recently 2.4.5 released, and we are using 2.4.4 version. And then Kafka 2.4.0 or 3.0, I'm not sure. So this question will be covered. And Airflow. This is a recent one. 1.10.8 will be following with small upgrades, and 10.9 will be integrated with Flask integration as well. So this version of software you will be covered, and we will be installed everything in that our VM. And in case of any changes in future, we will be updated and sharing that same directory. So you'll download and practice yourself. Why am I providing with latest version? Once you learn and go for the interview timings, at the time this version will become a old. So you know very well what is the updates will happen, and you can efficiently can answer. So that's what we will be providing this versions of PM. Any question? A point something 3x version will be used. So with respect to Hadoop 3x, so few changes will happen. So that is also will be discussed, because mostly all the big data platform will migrate to Hadoop 3x version nowadays. So we have to know what is that importance with 3x, because Hadoop 1 and 2 is getting old. Any question? Next, project discussion. So it's completely followed with the real time, how the flow will be happen. So in this real time architecture, we will see batch processing. with respect to this ecosystems, and then go with streaming. Okay, so it will be covered at the session itself. And final, once it is done, we'll go with combined batch and stream. So that's already, I just mentioned with big data projects with 8 open source or something I just covered, right? So same session, I'll be covering you and providing that materials to you. So you can do your practice and you'll get the confidence in that. Okay, any question? So every topic covered, I will ask for that any doubts or questions from your end. If nothing, we can go for the next. Because my communication and your understanding should be synced, then only we can go for the next. That's a good way, I think so. I hope no. And interview perspective, we will not be helping you for no proxies, but we will help you interview tips. And tricks, as a panelist, I know how they will be asking the questions during the interview. So we will discuss that things. And any question updated or newly, or you'll get faced in interview, but you cannot answer, you just bring that question. We will be discussing the things that we will help you. This is a console basis only, so we cannot assure how long it will be take, but as per previous batch, it will go with 2 to 3 months. With respect to your doubts, so everything will be covered. So that we cannot assuring you the timings and class durations. So minimum 30 duration and maximum will go with 40, 50. Okay. Any other question?
So what is the programming language you will be teaching?
For Spark, that as per your decisions, your batch is planned to go with Scala, I'm fine. Because I have worked with the Scala and Python both. So which one you needed, that's your batch going to decide. I will not be decide this source. But anyone. And I am working with my platform. I just working with the finance team, finance and banking. And then on IoT is a streaming platform. Right now I'm working with streaming analytics plus ML integration. So I just working with Scala and Python both. So I have experience in that. But as per your batch, which one will be planned, I will be taking that. That's not an issue. Decision yours. But Airflow completely in Python only. We don't have any other language in Airflow. So that should be go with Python. But Spark, if needed, I can cover with Scala. That's, I will give you your opinions, your batch opinions. Because few of them will be balanced with Python and few of them will be balanced with Scala. So which one you will be feel as a comfortable, I will be go with.
Like for example, like a mapper, do we really need a mapper at this point or we can just go with Apache?
Apache Spark only mapper is not required. Because map reduced, nobody is using right now.
Right.
Entirely, they just migrate into the Spark only. So all the classes with the Spark, that will be integrated with the Kafka, Hive, like that only. Because Spark is important. To compare with other ecosystems, Spark will take long time. And each topic will be covered. We will be going to interact, to integrate with other ecosystem aspects.
And either if you are using a Scala or Python, so we will work on the Python, for example, PyCharm on a local machine, and then we can connect to an HDFS edge node, or is it like?
No, that PyCharm I will give you here. So this is the sample VM. I am doing end-to-end testing from my end. I will give you this VM. Here I can install PyCharm and all other tools as well. So you can directly use it here itself.
But in the real world, we will not be doing like this, right? We will be connecting to a edge node, Unix system.
Yeah.
And we will not be directly writing the programs there. We will be writing on a local machine and then move the program files to your repository and then move from there, right?
Yes, exactly. I agree with your point. That's we will go with real-time discussion, right? This time, like that, we will be doing. And how we need to connect with the PuTTY, that also we can see.
Yeah.
Okay. So PuTTY connection, WinSAP integration.
WinSAP. Yeah. Without WinSAP also, can we do the file movements from?
Itexia is possible. Lot of tools is available. PSSCP.
Okay. PSFTP or something. Yeah. Yes.
PSCP, I guess. So something we can migrate our data to that environment and we can do the practice. That is also possible. So in real time, we will be develop the code in outside and then we just migrate into the environment. So that's we will be covered with the project discussions on how we can log in with PuTTY. So these are also basic and you need to know. So that we will be helping you. You will be feel something close to real time. Because the reality will help you for to clear the interviews. I know that well, and I will cover this part. Okay, any question?
Will you show any framework which is needed like for a pipeline ingestion? For example, all the files will come into a network drive. Can we do something using a PySpark, any small framework which will cover all the scenarios of all the file formats, and then one pipeline will take care of the all the ingestion process? Is that?
Yeah, exactly. That will be covered here. That's I just mentioned the batch processing and stream processing, right? So here, while you are studying, at the time you know that file formats, Pocket, OSI, RC. So that will be GitHub platform file formats. So that will be handled here. So that will be covered. So in batch processing, the real-time architecture also, we will be go with one file from Hive and another one will be covered from our local. And finally, it will be migrated into the Hadoop environment or RDBMS table. So it's a combined in batch processing, the basic flow you can get. That is actually the people will be doing. So one, they will be going to interact with Hive environment. Another one will be in direct file format or local file or something, whatever. We just cover and we will be make some joins and final output will be going to store in RDBMS. So you know how that RDBMS will be interact with the Spark as well as Hive and other tools. That you can understand. Here also streaming also will be covered with Kafka integrations, how streaming flow will be happen and how we will be going to store the data. this is separated, but most of the people will be asking that big data projects, but this project, mostly the people will be expected in previous batch. So that once it is covered, at last I'll cover with command batch and stream processing with the Airflow scheduling. That I will help you. So you'll get clarity where you'll be stuck and where you'll be facing some issues.
Okay.
That I will help you.
So, like, can you show any PySpark, in the real-time project architecture?
Yeah.
So, like the PySpark framework where I can get ingestion from an RDBMS table. Instead of writing for each table separately, I want to write one common code, which I can pass as a table name and an offset or primary key or last modified date column. And then automatically the pipeline should take care of the ingestion.
That is a scope incremental import operation that we will be covering. So if you need a Spark also, we can go over the notions.
Okay.
So scope, that's a syllabus. I think we will not be seeing the syllabus. This is the old one, I guess. Okay, this is Spark. Okay. Okay, so scope jobs and incremental operation will be covered in scope itself. So here I just mentioned, right? So I can follow up with the same. Spark only, I just providing you in detail, because these are the basics. So we will be covered with the Spark very well. That's an important.
Right.
Then only you'll get satisfied, and we are also getting some job satisfaction. So we'll be giving more important with the Spark enrollment. And completely in hands-on only.
Hands-on means like you will be doing and we'll also be doing.
I will do, and I will share the codes to you. You can do the practice, and if you face any issues, we will discuss. That is the one day discussions.
No.
Because I can do it by my own, but you need to understand. That's an important.
Right.
So that I just making the session like this. It's not a 4 days training and 1 day discussion. Each topic will be covered and you have to do practice, and 1 day we'll go with discussion that. Any other question? I just said clearly what we are going to discuss. If no, then go for some Hadoop basics. Okay, so we'll discuss now. Hope you don't have any question in that class introductions. So you'll get some clarity in that, I guess. Any question? Okay. So welcome to Vidra. Okay, so in Hadoop 3 we will be discuss. So before starting that Hadoop, we just going to discuss about databases. So history of databases is important. So based on that, the database will come from network, relational, distributed, and object. So this is the flow. At the beginning, we will be get from network databases only. So 1973, Charles W. Backman will be introduced. So simply we just migrating our data. That only will be helped. Correct? Then relational databases, RDBMS in 1981 will be introduced. Do you know this guy? Edgar F. Co. Anyone can remember this guy? Who is he? How many of you know about normalizations? What are the types of normalizations available? Anyone? First normalization, second normalization, third normalization, BCN of Bayes code normalization form. Nowadays, all the relational database will be moved into this Bayes code normalizations only. So that was introduced in 1981 by this guy. And nowadays we are following that only. And distributed databases, that will be close to 2000 was introduced. Across the multiple branches, we can integrate with normalization concept. So primary key and foreign key relationship, that we will be migrating. And 2014 onwards, we will be migrating to the object. What is object databases? Anyone? Modern databases means, did you hear about anything in modern database? It's not a data, it's object-based databases. Everything will come to this modern databases. Okay, then we just go with big data layers. So in big data, as a big data is a term and Hadoop is a framework term. Many of them is confused. Big data is used for the term only, terminology only. Hadoop is actual framework tool. Like that, we have multiple big data tools is available like SingSort and the other tools as well. So in big data, we will be split into the four layer: storage, processing, resource management, and ecosystem integrations. So this four, better I can go with this Hadoop treatment. Name node, data node. Secondary name node. Resource manager. The job tracker. Node manager or task tracker. Application master. Container. Heartbeat. Block size, yarn, Yeah, and difference between two is three. So what is the difference between Hadoop 2 yarn and 3 yarn? And then high availability. Yarn, name node, data node, secondary name node, resource manager, node manager, application master, container, heartbeat, block size, yarn, high availability. Zookeeper, replication factor, Erasure encoding will be in Hadoop 3 and R of quotes and XR gateways and Erasure encoding, out of quotes, XR gateways, and parity block. Okay. And fault tolerance. Name node, data node, secondary name node, process manager, application node manager, heartbeat blocks, is yarn, high availability, bookkeeper, replication master, fault tolerance, input split, FS images. Edit logs, log, what? One total 18. That's encoding, block report, fault tolerance, FS images. Did I miss anything? Blocks with heartbeat, container, split, FS images, edit log, and block reports. So what is name node? You may study something, right? Can anyone tell me what is name node?
Name node, which is the main cluster name or.
Okay, so let me go with some cluster. So let's say I'm using final cluster. One should be a master as per Big Data platform. One should be a master. The rest of that will come to this slave. So slave one, slave two, slave three, like slave four and slave five. Okay, so all this slave only have actual data. Whatever the data will combine, that will be stored in this only. So here only all the data will be stored. So like a blocks. So name node is nothing but these, all the metadata information will be stored. So what are the data that you'll be stored? That metadata information will be stored in master. This master will be called as name node. This Hadoop concept entirely copied from Google file system only. So here you can see the examples. So here that's a GFS client and GFS most and chunk servers available. So in GFS chunk server have actual data and GFS master can understand where the data will be stored with respect to of directory and file size and replication details. Everything will be stored here only. So this chunk server, whenever the client will be raised the request, the master will be received and it will be going to interact with your data nodes and final output will be sent back to this client. This is the same flow in Hadoop also they are doing, but the instead of master they are seeing as a name node. As well, chunk server, they are saying as a data node. So whenever the client will be raised a request, name node going to interact with your data node with respect to metadata information. This information, once it is received, then do some process analysis via YARN architecture. So YARN will be doing that MapReduce processing, and then final output will be providing to the client information. So the same flow, they will be copied from Google file system. So this is called as name node. So metadata, reference, and data indexing information. Both will be available in name node only. Then data node. As I said, actual data will be stored. As blocks. So default block size. How much?
128.
In Hadoop one?
64.
Why they have increased to 128? Any idea? Do you know what is the block size of BIOS or Linux environment? Anyone? Windows environment only 128 KB and Linux environment will be in 4 MB. Why we need to provide this much block size? What is the reason behind? Any guess? Anybody here that Hadoop environment that people will be suggesting to go with big sizes of files, not for the small files? So what is the reason behind?
Actually, if we have small sizes, it will need more memory to store the file information. So it will take more number of more memories in the more memory in RAM actually.
Okay.
Or in the name node.
Okay.
If we have smaller size, whereas if we have one big file size, then we don't really need to have, like it will store only one time and the size may be like in 1 MB or something, or 1 KB.
Exactly. So name node will getting burdened. So you cannot do your operation very efficiently. And as well, if the same small files, it will be replicated. So main node will have all the information with replication as well. So metadata will be in huge and you'll be getting delays while doing the performances. That is the reason they are suggesting to load as a big files, because big files means they will be considered as a single file and those metadata information will be locked as a chunk sizes. So whenever the query will be come to this client, immediately name node will be understand. Let's say for example, I'm the client. I'm going to interact with the name node and do some analysis with 10 GB of data. So some files with the 10 GB of data. So a name node is going to be identified. If it is only for 5 files, name node only get that metadata information about the 5 files only and do the processing immediately with respect to YARN architecture. So some YARN separately is available. Once name node can identify where the data is available, then it will be immediately informed to YARN team. YARN can identify how much resources needed and going to work with your environment. As a jobs and tasks, it will be going to work. So let's say if I have that metadata information very huge, then YARN is going to be considered and each will be created multiple tasks and doing the performance. So it will take long time and each mapper, it will be take different, each file size as an input split, it will be take multiple tasks. So number of thread you need to use it more. That we need to reduce. That's the reason they will be suggesting you to load into the big file sizes. Okay, got it. So two things, one is name node burden, another one is the replication factor, the data will be multiple mapper will be can create it. So we need to avoid that. That's the reason we will be suggesting to go with big file sizes. Any question?
Here I have one doubt here. The client is giving 10 GB file.
Okay.
At present, as per peak, we have 5 data nodes, right?
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, how many split it will divide into number of pieces to store into that?
No, actual the file size is 10 GB, but based on the blocks, it will be split into 128 MB only. It's a physical and logical storage they are mentioning. That is called input split. So based on number of input split, it will be creating number of mappers.
Okay.
I will cover in number of input split that I mentioned here.
Okay.
So that time I will say, this is a physical storage, how the data will be loaded. This is logical way to understand about mappers.
Okay.
In detail, we will be discuss about this as well.
Okay, okay, thank you.
Okay, any question? I guess no. So this is the same, and this much speed only we will go for entire other ecosystem as well, I'm sure. Okay, so today is enough, I guess. You know the basics and we just discussed, and tomorrow we'll cover entire the demons. Okay. Any other questions or any question you can raise me now. If not, we can wind up the session today. Any question? Okay, thank you all. We'll be continuing back by tomorrow from where we have left. Thank you.
Thank you.